Hello friends, I'm Shraddha and I will be talking about Henry Gustav Mollison. Henry Gustav Mollison was born in 1926 and he was the most studied patient in the history of neuroscience. He had the world's most famous brain. He began to have minor seizures at the age of 10 and had major seizures after the age of 16 due to epilepsy. Each seizure lasted around 40 seconds. His epilepsy was thought to be because Henry had been knocked down by a bicycle and hit his head when he was 9. Henry started having over 10 epileptic seizures a day, which made it almost impossible for him to have any kind of life. He was prescribed very high doses of anticonvulsant medications, but they were ineffective. Years later, he met Dr. William Scoville, who believed removing Henry's hippocampus from his brain would reduce his seizures and cure his epilepsy. Dr. Scoville, in the year 1953, suggested an experimental operation called the bilateral medial temporal lobe resection. Henry would be the first patient suffering from epilepsy to undergo this procedure. It was previously done in patients who had schizophrenia. Henry agreed to the surgery, and at the age of 27, he was operated upon to remove the medial temporal lobe, including both the hippocampus and most of the amygdaloid complex. Once he was out of surgery, doctors realized that Henry could recall all of his old memories from before the surgery without major problems, but he couldn't remember even the simplest new memories. He could not remember what he ate for lunch or recall the names of doctors that he met just a few minutes before. Although Henry's epilepsy seemed to be gone, he could no longer make memories. His short-term memory was intact, but he failed to convert short-term memories into long-term memories. He then got diagnosed with anterograde amnesia. Anterograde amnesia is the inability to develop and keep new memories. Most of his memories from before the operation remained, except some part of the past 11 years, that is, partial retrograde amnesia. Retrograde amnesia is a form of amnesia where someone is unable to recall events that occurred before the development of the amnesia. In Henry's case, before his surgery, he could not convert new memories into long-term memory. He was able to carry on normal conversations, that is, had some capacity for working memory, but he would forget what the conversation was about immediately. His semantic memory prior to the operation was intact. He recalled historical facts, recognized relatives, had a good vocabulary, and had intact procedural memory. Eventually called patient HM to preserve his identity, he was analyzed and studied for over 50 years of his life until he died at the age of 82. Due to constant study of Henry, doctors were able to learn what the hippocampus actually does. The hippocampus is the part of the brain that takes current short-term memories and moves them into long-term memories. Without this crucial piece, a sensory impression fades and vanishes in 30 seconds, and the brain cannot make long-term memories. It informed neurosurgeons that a bilateral lesion of a medial temporal lobe structure placed recent memory functions at risk. It suggested that the establishment of memory had a distinct neural substrate. Memory for new experience was disturbed, but other cognitive functions and sensory capacities were unimpaired. But since he had some memory from his past, it suggested that some memory formation, particularly motor skill learning, occurred without the hippocampus. This image shows the comparison between a normal human brain and Henry's brain. As you can see, the hippocampus is missing from Henry's brain. HM was able to retain some memories for events that happened long before his surgery. This indicates that the medial temporal region within the hippocampus is not the site of permanent storage in itself, but it plays a role in how memories are organized and then stored elsewhere in the brain. The fact that HM and other people with amnesia have defects in some types of memories, but not in others, is taken as evidence that the brain has multiple memory systems that are supported by distinct brain regions. After Henry's death in 2008, his brain was dissected into 2,000 slices and digitized as a three-dimensional brain map that could be searched by zooming in from the whole brain to individual neurons. Thank you.